Yes, so myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs for phase 1 of your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examination. So SEBI phase 1 of 2020 examination has been over. So the SEBI students are required to relax themselves and they can start preparing for their phase 2 examination. And this series is for the aspirants who are appearing for RBI, SEBI, NABARD as well as those who want to appear for banking exams at the level of PO. So let's begin this video. And but before that, I would like you guys to subscribe and hit this bell notification. If you are seeing this video for the first time, if you are seeing our channel, you are coming on our channel for the first time, then subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we provide the free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. Also guys, if you like the videos, then do share it with your friends and spread the knowledge. This reminds me that the people who want to appear for SEBI graded 2021, those who are watching me right now, can watch the SEBI graded 2020 analysis of GK questions which was uploaded yesterday. And also SEBI grade A ke other question papers ki bhi analysis by Shubham Singhania has been uploaded on our channel. So go watch those sessions and have a good idea about the type of questions that are asked in the SEBI examination. So for the time being, let's begin this video with the first question. So we have, which company has manufactured India's first indigenously designed and developed driverless metro car? So we have Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, Bharat Electronics Limited, Mazagon Dock Ship Builders, BEML, which was earlier known as Bharat Earth Movers Limited, Bharat Dynamics Limited. So which one of the options is the right answer? So the right answer is option B, BEML. Now I am 100% sure that many of you are getting confused about the first driverless metro that was inaugurated by Prime Minister Modi in Delhi and this first indigenously designed and developed driverless metro car which has been inaugurated in Mumbai. What's the difference? The difference is that it is the indigenously developed and designed metro car, which is driverless, of course. So which company has developed this car? It's BEML, and it has got the contract of manufacturing over 500 such metro cars for the Mumbai Metropolitan Development Authority. So that's all for this news. I hope that this question is clear to you now and you don't have any kinds of doubts. Okay, but my question for you remaining. My question for you is that, do you guys remember that when I have taught you about the national mobility card, I have told you that there would be AFC gates. That will enable the users to use their smartphones as their transit card. So a company was given the contract to develop these AFC gates for the Delhi Metro. Which company is it? So tell me this question in the comment section below so that I know whether you are following the morning tales or not. So mention this question. This is an important question, guys. Okay, so we are on our second question. So with which country has India signed an MOU to enhance cooperation in the field of information and communication technology, including 5G standardization? So this MOU was announced earlier only. Now you have to tell me which country is this. So is it Philippines, Netherlands, Japan, Australia or USA? Which one is it? So the right answer is option C, it's Japan. It is with Japan that India has signed this MOU for the information and communication technology under which 5G standardization will be done. They will cooperate for 5G network and they will cooperate for telecom sector as well. So that's all for this question. Next question is, where is the newly created CSIR National Institute of Science Communication and Policy Research located? So you have Balasore, Sriharikota, Mangalore, Bangalore and New Delhi. In the options, what is the right answer? Where is this newly created lab of CSIR located? So the right answer is option E, New Delhi. It is located in New Delhi. Now this has been created by merging the two existing CSIR institutions, and the name of those institutions are the two CSIR laboratories or institutions which have been merged for creating the CSIR National Institute of Science, Communication and Policy Research. So the first institute is National Institute of Science, Communication and Information Resources. Second is National Institute of Science, Technology and Development Studies. So guys, these two organizations or these two institutions are located in New Delhi itself. So these are some of the facts related to this question. My question from you is the chair of CSIR. And under which ministry does this CSIR, which is an autonomous organization, operates? These two questions are for you. You have to mention the answer of these two questions. So the next question is, recently two Doppler weather radars were established in two states at Mukteshwar and Kufri. So basically in two states, at these two places, this Doppler weather radar has been established. Where are these two places located? So is it Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh, Rajasthan and West Bengal, Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh, Meghalaya and Maharashtra, or Andhra Pradesh and Punjab? Which one is the right answer? So the right answer is option A, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. This Mukteshwar is in Uttarakhand and Kufri is in Himachal Pradesh. Also remember that the Doppler weather radar located at Mukteshwar is Uttarakhand's first Doppler radar weather radar system. What is the use of this weather radar system? Basic use is to forecast the weather condition. That's all, that is the only use. Now I have told you that this is the first Doppler radar system of Uttarakhand. Then what is the, or where is the India's first Doppler radar system located? So it was established in the year 2002 in Uttarakhand, in Chennai. So this fact is also important. Remember that the first one was established in Chennai, and recently two radar systems have been established at these two places and the states where these two places are located. So that's all for this question. With which company has Indian Army partnered for switch UAV system for surveillance operations? So basically it's a 20 million project contract given to a company for procurement of this switch UAV systems. Now, which company has got this contract? Is it Skyroot Aerospace Private, Dhruv Space, Idea Forge, Pixel or Dell Technologies? Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option C, Idea Forge. So this is a very basic simple question, but an important one as well. You have to remember three facts here, three keywords here. First is Keyforge, second is Indian Army, and third is Switch UAV. And the purpose of this Switch UAV is surveillance. So that's all from this question, but my question from you is that who is the chief of Indian Army? This person has been in the news. I have discussed the questions related to the Indian chief, Army chief many times, even in the SEBI grade A revision series as well. Now it is your task to mention that who is the chief of Indian Army in the comment section below. So this is the last question of our day. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of Telecom Equipment and Services Export Promotion Council? You have Vipul Bansal, Vivek Singh, Sandeep Agarwal, Anil Yadav, Amrish Sharma in the options. The right answer is option C, Sandeep Agarwal. He is the new chairman of this organization. So here this session ends. I hope that you have found it useful and it has added to your knowledge. And if it has, then do share it with your friends and like this video. Thank you so much for watching this video.